The history of the Episcopal Church began in 1607 when three ships with 144 people sailed 4 months across the Atlantic from England to occupy Jamestown, Virginia. Just as colonists began to see themselves as a new nation apart from England, they saw their church as separate from the Church of England. The birth of the Episcopal Church followed the birth of a new nation when the first American bishop, Samuel Seabury, was consecrated in 1785 by Scottish bishops who didn't require that he swear an oath to the king. 4 years later, the Episcopal Church passed its own constitution and adopted its first American Book of Common Prayer. The history of the Episcopal Church has been forever intertwined with the history of the nation. During the first half of the 1800s, strong missionary work helped the church grow from 400 to over 2,000 congregations. America was a nation of slavery and racial bigotry, and the Episcopal Church participated in and benefited from the enslavement of hundreds of thousands of Africans. Still, the spirit of African Americans was strong. Absalom Jones, born enslaved in 1746, fought his freedom and became the first African American priest in the Episcopal Church in 1802. Harriet Tubman Ross, an African American who fought for the freedom of enslaved people in the 1800s, was also an Episcopalian. The Episcopal Church never took an official stance against slavery during the Civil War. In 2015, Michael Curry became the first African American presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, introducing the church to the language of love and the Jesus movement. After the end of the Civil War, American industry grew by leaps and bounds. People moved away from farms and small towns to cities. Factories offered poor working conditions, low wages, and long hours. Some in the Episcopal Church, like William Augustus Muhlenberg, responded with caring acts, starting schools and funds for the unemployed. In the late 1800s, the Women's Auxiliary provided funding for church-wide programs to help people in need. But women couldn't participate fully in church leadership. Not until 1974 were women ordained in the Episcopal Church. In 2009, the Episcopal Church elected its first female presiding bishop, Catherine Jefford Shorey. The Episcopal Church is a human institution, sometimes failing to live up to the values of the gospel, but working to face our history. Today, the church is looking hard at its history of racism. With God's help, together, we will live into a better future. Knowing our history will help us move forward as a people rooted in Jesus and working to do God's work.